this new dance craze called acid. What people really want to know is how the story all goes about acid. This is acid. I'm gonna give you acid. This is acid. I'm giving you acid.
Hey guys, how are you? Welcome. I'm going to do another exciting episode today of Toys in My Closet, but it's basically to showcase and show my two pieces of Masters of the Universe vintage lore, because it's older and more of the newer lore from the newer collection of Motu Classics, based on the Mattel updated versions of the old school vintage toys, toy line itself. And because big shout outs to my friend and dear, compatriot, Master Chief. He told me basically would love to see what the castle looks like for the new one. And I said, okay, I'll try my best to do a video. So this is basically to dedicate it to him as a, you know, because he asked me to do it as, for him, I guess, or basically so he can see it. So I'm going to take the time to do it now for him. And there's other reviews out there with plenty of Castle Grayskull reviews on the classic one, but I guess he wanted to see how I did it in my style, explaining what I thought and my thoughts about him. So we'll start off, as you see here in the front, this one here on what would be you guys is right, is the classic Castle Grayskull from the Masters of the Universe Classics line from Mattel. And this one here is the Castle Grayskull for the 2000X cartoon, and also from Mattel. And also, I believe, was from Cartoon Network. So as you can see, as far as the height goes, they look almost pretty close in size. But when it comes to scale and detail, accessories, and sculpting, they're very different and very in a very big way. And there's a lot of big, more, if you will, of structural content on this castle here from the classic line. So I'll come in this way and we'll talk about this castle here. And as you guys see here, it has the classic turret with the flag. And one of the things there with the flag here, for example, is that we'll notice right off the back, for all you guys that are Motu fans, that this flag used to have on the vintage one two sides. One would be for heroic, one would be for the evil symbol of, you know, of the evil warriors, in case whoever took control of the castle would man the flag in whoever was controlling it at that moment. And one of the things that was really nice about the Castle Grayskull lore was nobody really controls Castle Grayskull. It's a power, an entity on its own. And basically, you needed the powers of the two half swords, which one was wielded by He-Man and the other was wielded by Skeletor. If you put them together, whoever had those two halves would be able to access and get control of all the castle's secrets and powers in the chambers of Castle Grayskull. So, for starters, with me, what I didn't like from the 2000X line is, one, it looked more high-tech than gothic and grim, like the original, you know, design. Plus, I didn't like that they put the crescent here, as you see here, in the front of He-Man's harness, like it always belongs to He-Man. I felt that kind of took away the mystique and majestic kind of feel of the castle not being owned by anyone, but for those who have control of the two halves of the sword. You see there also, you see a chromatic chrome version of He-Man's newer sword, or power sword in the 2000X, which is supposed to be in the vault within the castle, displaying out the window, which I thought was kind of cheesy. And I know it's for play value. What they did with this castle, if you look down here, there's like these pieces that look kind of like they have batteries perhaps underneath it. It's because this castle is electronics. Same thing if you notice with the eyes. They have like these see-through covers on them as the eyes light up. So what they did, these were the figures in scale for this collection. I only have this He-Man out because I have it put away in my closet, so he's the only one that I had closest access to. And this is like I think it's like a jungle powered He-Man or something like that. He has like a special harness and suit. It had a lot of more play value when they did these different variations of He-Mans for the kids, obviously. And they were really nice looking, don't get me wrong, but they weren't, they were only like 5 points of articulation on them. But they are in scale, if you see. And the castle does, you know, open the drawbridge. The drawbridge there, but as you see, it's not really that detailed. It's mainly flat. And it's sculpted really nice, but again, I don't like the crescent. So what we'll do here is I'll turn it around sideways so you guys can see. If you turn it here on the side, you'll see this is one of the pieces for the side of the castle. And this looks very nice. The detail, sculpting, it's really, really well done. But it's like really a small piece. As you can see, my hand right there kind of fills it all up. So it's not really super duper long. My hands are like maybe 7 inches long or something like that. So you figure about there. From here to here, this side is a little bigger, obviously. There you go. This side has a bigger half. This is more like, I would say, close to 10, maybe 11 inches. And again, you see it's supposed to be the drawbridge and a secret path, passage door, which in the new one it has. But they created a really cool component that goes along with it. So here's the other half. Then what we'll do is we'll turn it around and go to the inside of the castle. And I'll turn it as carefully as I can so you guys can take a look. And this is what the inside of the castle looks like. You'll notice immediately that the castle has really nice right there, that it has the chamber door opening, saying that, showing you that the sword is in there, right? It has this panel here to walk. You'll notice it has the drawbridge from the classic, but no longer is there even a throne. You just have this here. This actually opens up here. If you open this up here, both sides, and it opens up this door. But it opens electronically when you place the figures on these electrical emblems. You see how it has the form of a foot? When you put the foot there of the figure, it would, you know, turn on. Over here, down here, we'll go down here. We turn it on here. I don't think.
The spirit of Grayskull awakens.
So yeah, the batteries do work. If you put the figure here, let me see if it does it still. If you put the figure here, let me change the hand. Put the figure right there like this, like so. It was basically activate. I think this one doesn't have it because, oh, it's this side, it's this side. It's supposed to be the ones that look like this underneath. I don't think it's activated because of the armor that he has on his foot, as you see there. So that would turn on. And then if you see there, that's also like a, that's also like, what you call it? That's also a, let's see, turn on the light. There we go.
that's also like a the control compartment from the original is down here now, instead of being on the top. Then you have this little panel here where you can sit, and here would be what was the case to prison the bad guys. It's not closed in, it's kind of open, and you see it has here these handcuffs or shackles, so you can put against the wall. Then if you came here, with this little lever here, you can open the door. So what I'll do is, and then over here, this is the key for the secret chambers. It's really big, it's kind of exaggerated, and I think it's mainly for kid play value. I have this on, yeah, just so that you guys can see for the moment. And then over here would be the weapons wall. Instead of having, you know, the weapons rack, it's a weapons wall. And I'm missing one of the weapons because I accidentally lost it. Didn't realize it until some years later that it was lost. But here it is. This is the weapons, no weapons rack. So you see it's very bare, and I'll show it from this far out. It's a very bare minimum, as you can see. It's not as, as full inside as even the original that came with a number of things. Came with, a ladder, an elevator, a throne, and even had some, had obviously the flag, the turret lasers, and it had also a workout bench contraption where they would fight with their weapons to practice. So what I'll do is, one more time, just so you guys can see it in effect, I'll turn it back on.
The spirit of Grayskull awakens.
You guys can hear that. And then turn it around from the front, and you can see here that what it looks like lit up. See? So it was a cool feature that none of the other ones had. And this castle, because of this electronic feature at the time, then you open this here, push it to the side, like so, and now the drawbridge can and will open. Let me see if I can push it from the side here. There you go. It usually opens when you put the figure on it, obviously, in the inside. So, like so. Again, like I said, it's within scale. But with him having this piece here, you can't go through it. I would have to remove it off of him. But that's what it looks like.
Please secure the drawbridge.
So, you can close it like so.
Drawbridge secured. Grayskull secured.
See? And it tells you. So what I'll do here now is I'll take a quick pause, since we have it there, and then we'll go to the next one, and I'll show you what it looks like when you close it to store it, to put it away. So guys, what would seem like I didn't do anything, now I would show you what it looks like when you close it up and store it to take it and put it away. And that's what it looks like, just like the classic. The only thing it's missing is basically the handle, and this is how thin it looks from the side. So this was a solid piece, for sure. A lot of people didn't like it, a lot of people did like it. It had mixed feelings for a lot of Motu fans, which means Masters of the Universe, only abbreviated. And I understand, because the classic one was really iconic and a really hard piece to kind of duplicate, if you will. Even things like Snake Mountain, Fright Zone, and Eternia fell a little short from the original. So I'm going to move this to the side and put it down like so. And then we're going to go here to the new one from Mattel. And this is the new Castle Grayskull. And as you can see, it's built to scale with the 7-inch figures. This here is Fisto. As you can see, this is a version that looks like the stone that make it look like a statue inside the castle of King Grayskull, which is He-Man's ancestor in the that came from the 2000X lore. And then this here is Preternian He-Man, which is a evil version of He-Man, or anti-Venom, or anti-Eternian He-Man, or something like that. It's from the comic books in Europe, which they made a figure, which is really cool, with the black and red deco. He looks crazy. His eyes look really crazy with the eyeliners of red, as you can see. And here we go. As you can see, if you stand them in front, they're scaled pretty decent. Actuality, if you want to scale them to a more realistic size next to these figures, to be honest, it would be the castle will be super, super big. Massive. It's already as big as it is, especially as far as size, weight, everything. Like, this thing is big. And when I got this, I paid $289 with the shipping and everything. But now, you can only get it to the aftermarket. When you try to buy this thing, it goes for almost $600 sealed, closed. This is the drawbridge, with these nice pieces there. As you can see, it's painted and weathered very well, like gunmetal from weapons and from guns of today. The crest is very classic from the original, with weathering in green and in gold and some gunmetal gray as well. And what they did with this one is they did a little cool feature where you see that slot there, you go there, and if you put the hole there, I like the wood touches up here as well, and they did wood touches here on the window and the wood touches here. Let me take one of the swords here. As you see here, if you put the sword here and you press it in, it basically unlocks the door. I don't know if I'm doing it right or wrong, but it's supposed to. There it is. And there's the mouth. Really nice painted weathering, as you see here, with the blacks, hints of green, the shades of green over here as well. And over here. Really nice. This is what it looks like from the back or from afar. You go up here, and here you have a side panel where you could actually stand up figures on it. And this side panel here. The only thing bad mainly about this is that it collects a lot of dust and it's very hard to get it very clean. And there's a trap door here that opens up on the side and goes into the inside. And you can see a little bit of the throne there, then you come up this way and you'll see none other than your boy Mechanic on the turret. You pull him down. Very colorful. As you can see, Mechanic there. Even standing. And this is the turret. Classic style, classic look. Very well painted. With the down and up swivel. And you come up here and then you have the flag, the heroic flag, as I already pointed out to you guys. It's the heroic flag. But then if you turn it around, and it is removable. Oh, it came off. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. When you turn it around, opposite direction, now it has the symbols and crests of that it's being controlled by evil. So that's a really cool feature. These are one of the windows here. that I like very much. I don't know if you guys can see that filter coming in, but let me take a quick pause. His eyes painted in black, very nice. Turn that off, see, hold on. Then you have the nice window, like I said. So we'll turn it to the side here. And when you turn it, this is the side view of the Classic. As you can see, and there you have an idea of how really massive this is. It takes almost the whole entire table. This thing is massive. As with the other one, that one piece was the size of my hand. This is pretty much what my hand covers. Then you have all that extra. That's how massive it is in the width. We'll come up here and you see really nice weathering of the, you know, in wood. Just like the Classic. This is all Classic, very vintage, just like the vintage one. Two windows, the other window here with the wood paneling. Another window here with the wood paneling. This part here all nice and weathered and brown, would make it feel like wood. And then this piece was actually extra that you can choose to put on or not. And this is so that you can have the handle when you close it, store it, and can take it with you. And there it is. And then it has like a base, like it's sitting on top of rocks. Then this is a secret door they did. And the nice thing is, they made this little key that came with one of the characters named Scareglow. As you can see here, trying to, let me see if I can just put it there. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I'm gonna try. Oh boy, not cooperating. Anyway, and he was shackled with this key, Scareglow, if you will, because he was basically cursed. Knowing he has the key of Castle Grayskull, right there, but would never be able to open it. And it's very tiny. It'd never be able to open the castle. And then the piece that he brings, it has a little sculpted Castle Grayskull right on it, which is really cool. So you put the key here, and it goes in like so. You turn it, and when you turn it, you can actually open the door with the key. You just turn and then pull. And it actually works, which is really, really awesome. And then the inside is that steel plate in metal. So he basically had the access to the key, but because he was cursed, he could never go in it. Even though he had the key to get in Castle Grayskull. And that was the curse, that he can never get the powers because he was evil. And his name is Scareglow. I don't know if you guys even remember him. I'll try to show him before the end of the video so you guys see who he is. So then we'll turn it this way, just so you guys can see the inside now. And as we turn, you'll see, oof, this thing is really, really loaded to the T. It has a bunch of things that came with it. And we'll start up here. As you can see, this is the new design for the throne room. Very classic, with the two old school, but now they're plastic flags. In the original, they were just stickers. And then you turn this here, and you're gonna see how when you turn it, the drawbridge goes down. That's how the original was. The latch was the one who made sure that the drawbridge stayed up, like so. excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to turn on the light again. There we go. And this here is supposed to be the two power swords. That are, those are like, I guess, replicas. It came with extras that you could put up there to symbolize He-Man here. And this one here with the ruby is She-Ra. Then you can see that the computer's up in the top, like I said and showed you in the 2000X. It was in the bottom. This was in the top like the original. And this robot here was a piece of cardboard, which they actually did in full plastic casting and molded. And he's inside now, like an actual statue. Then up here, this is what the turret looks like. This has the panel up here. It has a secret compartment here that opens up, which this crystal goes in. I forgot the name of it. And that crystal you got when you bought another figure. Because what they did was, in order for you to fully accessorize the castle, you had to buy different pieces. Like the weapon rack was sold separately. Go here. Then there's another platform here where you can place figures like so. Right up here. And they stand there. Really cool. And then it has a little stairs. Then this here is the top part of the elevator. You can actually remove these heads and put them on a buck of one of the figures to make it look like a gold skeleton, which is pretty cool, especially when you try it on Skeletor. Going down, here's the second floor. That was the third floor. They have the other computer that, again, this was in the actual toy vintage. All this stuff here was cardboard. Then you go here, you see the computer with the old graphic design, and it's a sticker, I believe, in that one. And then this here is basically a flight pack that you can put on one of the figures, like this harness here, as you can see, but it looks like in the form of a hawk. And it's money green, which is very nice. So then we pull back, and now we'll go down here to the first floor, which there is the door that I opened up from the outside, the crystal chamber crest holder, and this came with the white sorceress from the Comic-Con exclusive. I believe it was the New York Comic-Con. Here is the actual piece I was talking about that they use to basically, use the weapons. It's a mechanism that turns around, and it's so they can practice using their weapons. And that's, I have it right there, right in the middle. And it has the shield that you can actually remove. That's a design. It's an actual shield. I'm trying to get better lighting. You can remove as a design. You stick it up here by the sword in the wall. He looks like He-Man shield, just all in silver. And the elevator is movable. It goes up and down, as you can see there, like the original. It goes even up to the third floor, as you see there. You make believe characters come down. Boom, and they got pegs. You can peg it right on there. For example, peg them there. Then you peg the other peg there, like so. And there you go. And then you can just pretend that he's going down. There you go. Second floor, even to the first floor. Here we go. Mechanic's neck is too long. He's already at the second floor with his neck. Anyway, we'll move this way. And this here is the chamber with the prison. Very nicely done. This was supposed to be a plastic piece that looked like what it was supposed to look like. The sticker, it was going to be molded. And there's some people that made it aftermarket that actually fits, and then you can actually put it in there. Then this is the door. It came with a chain shackle. Kind of plasticky, but it feels pretty sturdy. And you can close it. There's the door. Then you move over here. And this is the weapons rack, which I told you guys, it's a separate piece, as you can see, but you have to buy it separately because the castle was so expensive to make, they had to cut some corners and have you buy some of the pieces separate. And then these base came with it to give it kind of a floor that the original one never had that matches. And this here is a manhole top that was created by an aftermarket guy, did a fantastic job. The crescent of He-Man, and then the bottom looks like actual wood finish. And this was created to cover this because it didn't come with anything to cover it. And basically, this is a like a plastic piece, but you attach the stand for the Wind Raider or the jet sled, and you can put it inside and display it on the inside. And then, of course, last but certainly not least, it has the ladder, the classic traditional ladder that came with it. And you just place it there on the side and you bring it up. So when they did this, and this is really nice, this was made, like I said, by a third party, like another person, aftermarket, that he sculpts and designed, fixed perfectly. And it's just to make it look more presentable as a whole piece, especially if you don't want to put the Wind Raider attached there or the jet sled. To be honest, for me, it doesn't look right because they're very big pieces and it looks like it wouldn't fit. It doesn't look right in scale. So I don't like it. So I bought it. It was about $15, but I think it was well worth it because it fits the deco very well. So, you know, if you look from the outside in, this is what it looks like as a whole. Turn them back a little bit more. So this is the actual castle as a whole. And please forgive me that it's going to look like it's wobbling and moving because I am doing it with my, you know, selfie stick to be able to get in and out more thoroughly than I would if I had it on my tripod. I'll put some more figures here just to fill it up, kind of. Fisto right there. One of my favorite figures and characters in the He-Man collection. Then I guess we can put maybe King Grayskull's statue figure. What's supposed to be like a statue figure somewhere up here as deco, or if not, no. Let's put him down here in the corner. Move this to the top like so. Boom, 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 like that. Put him here like in the corner, like that, like he's actually a statue in the corner, which I think is a little better fitting. And leave the battle practice contraption here. I forget what's the proper name for this, down here somewhere next to the elevator where Mechanic is residing. Put He-Man, anti-He-Man here, like he's going to attack, trying to come in as the villain. And that should give you a better perspective of the scale. I have four figures in there. They're all 7.5 inches. To give you an idea of the scale or sense of scale that this castle provides. Very beautiful piece. I'm so very, very, very pleased and lucky to have it in my collection. I have it in a certain spot. It's very hard to move around, but I'm very lucky and fortunate, I feel, to have it. So what I'm going to do now is zoom in here, and I'm going to pause, and then when I come back, you guys will see the castle closed up because you can actually store it. So I'll be right back. Give me a second, guys. So yeah, guys, this is what it looks like. Once again, from the front, this is open with the mouth open, drawbridge. Now, close the drawbridge, and then you see these are the pieces that come separate. Like I said, these are the floors, as you see here. And then these are the extra pieces. And when you store it, you have to kind of make it all fit there, so I just left them out for now. Like I said, they come extra. And then what I'll show you here is basically how it looks closed. So you turn it around. As you turn it around, you see this is the length of it closed. And the whole back end covers the is the same width and as the front. So you see it's completely closed and folded like the original, like so. And then this is the handle that you use to carry it. And over here are the latches to latch it sealed. So again, this is the Castle Grayskull from the newest Master of the Universe Classic Vintage line by Mattel. One of my holy grails, if not the biggest holy grail, until perhaps they make the Snake Mountain, which is supposedly going to come soon by Super 7. Word is it on the street is that it is going to be this year. So let's see what happens. That would be pretty fantastic and amazing. I don't know how much it'll be, because like I said, this was a piece that cost $250 or $230, and with the shipping and handling, it was almost $290. And this was back like 5 years ago. Let's put it here. So I'm going to give you one last glimpse with some of the main core characters in the front here for Master of the Universe. Like so. Mechanic. There you go. So I hope you like it, guys. That's my compare and contrast of the Castle Grayskulls from the vintage modernized version of Maddie Collector for the Masters of the Universe Classic compared to the 2000X version that I have. That was basically for the remodeled and revised version of He-Man, which I adored very much, with the exception of the toys not being as good as the classics, obviously, because of articulation and obviously the big oversized weapons that were very kiddish and not really for adult collectors, or appealing to adult collectors, if you would. So Chief and all those of you watch it, I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry for the shaky cam. Like I said, it's very hard because I use my selfie stick. But there it is. Enjoy, give a like, comment if you like, and let me know what you think. See you soon, guys, in the next episode. Peace.